You can get the results you want, right?
You know, here's what Ruben was extremely coachable to the system. You know, I said, hey, you got to schedule first, come to training. Came to training. I was like, you got to schedule a PBR. He scheduled a PBR, and I was like, you got to practice that script. That script will get people from your list to the living room. He was very coachable. Second thing he brought to the table is a work ethic. How many of you find out it's work ethic? But anything in life worthwhile is going to take work, yes or no?
Yes.
See, even though he was a full-time realtor and a full-time father and husband, he had a part-time to put in the ACN, but he gave a full-time effort on a part-time schedule. How many of you know what I mean by that? He never missed a Friday night leadership, never missed a Saturday training, never missed a national convention, you know, committed to his people. And the third thing he brought to the table is his reason for doing the business. And I feel that's one of the most important things you can have. Why are you sitting here this morning? Why are you going to give up some Saturdays, give up some evenings, and I'll learn a new skill set? Well, you know what his why was? To get time back with his family, to have that time and money together. You know, hit regional director in 72 days. He was one of the fastest regional directors ever in ACN. Hit regional vice president, became one of the first regional vice presidents in New York, and I'd like to give it back to Ruben. Congratulations. Back in the back, and you know, I remember when I came to New York about 5 years ago. Nobody was doing anything in ACN. Nothing's ever happened in New York, and you know, I met some great people that you know been in front of me today, like Michael Delmonico. Where's Michael Delmonico? You know, just a phenomenal, phenomenal human being. We wouldn't have anything in the New York marketplace, in Staten Island, if it wasn't for Michael Delmonico. He's a regional director, then a solo. I mean, just so proud of her. When she took a look at ACN, she didn't speak English very well. Meaning, not only did she have to learn English, but she stood up here today and trained. Wasn't that just great? She never missed a Friday, never missed a Saturday. You want to know what a champion looks like? I'd like to congratulate her. Congratulations. Everybody that's, you know, come out here this morning. See, you know what this tells me is, first of all, congratulations to you that you want something to change in your life. How many of you want something to change? How many of you want a better life for maybe you or your family or some reason you wouldn't come? Guys, that was me 15 years ago. Now, I'll give you my background real quick. I've been with ACN 15 years. My background is a broke car salesman. I was living paycheck to paycheck 15 years ago. I wasn't a positive guy. I was negative. And you know why I was negative? Because I realized what I was doing wasn't going to get me where I want to go. How about you go to work every day and realize it's not going to get you what you want? But that's all I had. I mean, I don't have a college degree. I was the guy that took two high schools to get out of high school. I wasn't the smartest guy. But you know, I was an open-minded guy. And I remember I got a phone call from a friend's mother, and she asked me a really simple question. She goes, do you look at other ways to make money? I said, yeah. She was great with that script. I asked her some questions, and you know what she told me about a guy that was having massive success doing something in the telecom business? And the reason I went to her living room wasn't because she answered my questions, was because she was telling me that about a guy that's having massive success making money in the telecom business. So I went over and I took a look at ACN, and I don't know about you, but when that video finished, it made sense, yes or no? I realized I got a cell phone in my pocket now, buddy. I could market these services and do something once you get paid over and over and over and over again for it. And that just made sense to me. Second thing I liked was a chance for me to own my own business. And I had no business being in business. I mean, I've never owned a business before, but ACN said, look, well, for $4.99, you can own a business. I mean, when they said $4.99, I got excited. How about you? How many of you are like, I know I'm in the right group? You know, I got $4.99. I get started, and they're going to teach me how to do it. There was people that were willing to help me. I got started that night. You know why? To show them I was serious. To show them I was somebody that they could, you know, depend on. I came to a training, and I just started introducing this to people. How many of you started introducing to people? And here's what you find. Some people said yes. Some people said, yeah, some people said that's the greatest opportunity in the world, and some people said, what? You're crazy for doing it, yes or no? I got the same responses. We continued on our first month. We made a couple $1,000. We did ETT and ETL. We were excited, and I just continued working with the company. 15 years later, we've amassed a fortune doing this. But how we did it by helping other people. How many of you like that part of this? It's about people helping people. Now, I'm more excited today because of the energy business. Anybody excited about the energy business?
Yeah.
Now, if you're not clapping or cheering, let me tell you what's going on. The government's deregulating this. Now, what does that mean? Is they went to the electric companies and gas companies and said, you have to allow competition. See, we're seeing history repeat itself. Everybody remember in the 80s when there was one phone company in this country called the Bells? Remember the Bell?
Yeah.
And in 1983, if you wanted to make a phone call, who did you use? And if you didn't want to use the Bell because you didn't like their price or their service, who did you use? Didn't exist, no one. And then they deregulated. Now, what's deregulated mean? They went to the Bells and said, you have to allow competition. You have to allow other people to participate in this industry. And people got started, and they started companies like Verizon. How many of you heard of Verizon? Big company today?
Right.
Probably one of the biggest in the world, yes or no? Right? And then you heard of a company called AT&T. Anybody hear of that company?
Yes.
Right? You realize they didn't exist in 1982. Wow. Didn't exist in 1982. But see, here's what entrepreneurs realize. We don't have to teach people how to use the phone, do we? Would you agree that Bell already did all the hard work, yes or no?
Yes.
What did Bell do? They put the lines in, they showed people they needed it, they built the customer, they created the need, they made the customer, and then they opened it up for people to go in and get as much as you want. We're doing the same thing in the energy business. How many of you like the fact you can get paid when people pay electric bills? How many of you like the fact you can get paid when people pay gas bills? See, think about these things. Would you agree if the economy goes straight south tomorrow, everybody in this room will be affected, yes or no?
Right.
But will we still pay our electric bill?
Yeah. Right.
We still pay our gas bill.
Right.
So you'll still make money. How do you like that?
Yeah.
Guys, when they got involved in energy, I live in Miami, Florida. I raced in New York. Why? Because this was the first state we opened up. I got off the plane and just started talking to people. And here's what I found. People look at other ways of making money here in New York, yes or no? People use electricity and gas here in New York, and there's entrepreneurs here, yes or no?
Right.
We built one of the fastest growing teams. We put on more customers than any other organization in the New York, New Jersey marketplace and exploded this market. There's people in this room that are getting straight rich doing what we're doing. Now here's the good thing. There's people in this room that have without built teams and they're making money over every dollar those customers are spending for life. Now, they did a great job of teaching you this. My job is to talk about mindset. And guys, this is the part I needed. When I entered ACN, I never owned a business. How many of you never owned a business? You know, I was making $29,000 a year selling cars, but here was my problem. I brought my mindset to the table. My wrong mindset. My broke car salesman mindset. And I remember I got involved in ACN, and this was the bigger thing in helping. Everybody see this? Professionals sort and amateurs convince and sell. How many of you have been convincing people? Why? How many of you agree that's difficult? Read up here. Sorting is fun, but convincing is draining. Be a professional, listen, sort, move on. And remember, a no may not be a no forever. See, here's a reality of everybody on your list. You ready? Some will. Some won't. So what? Someone's waiting next. See, you're going to find ACN's nothing but a game. Now, how many of you like to play games? Well, let me rephrase that. Make sure I'm talking to the right room of people, right? Now, how many of you have ever sat down in a game and said, look, I'm going to play this for a couple hours, and I want to lose the game? Has anybody ever done that?
No.
Good, so I'm talking to the right room of people. Because I'm going to teach you today how to win the game at ACN. But first thing, you got to be coachable. Everybody say coachable. Coachable, right? See, first thing you have to do is figure out what you're playing for. They call it a why. Why are you here this morning? What's your why? And if it don't make you cry, it's not big enough. Now, guys, when I got started in ACN, I had three whys. Because my mentor was like, Mike, you have to know what you're playing for. I said, well, this is simple. Money, money, and money. He goes, Mike, if it was about money, you'd already be rich. He goes, it has to be something greater than money. And I see some perplexed faces here, and that was me. Because I was like, I don't get it. He goes, I'll give you an example. Imagine if I put a beam up here across this room. And I said, I'll give $1,000 cash to anybody come up and walk the beam. How many of you come up and walk the beam? Everybody, right? You walk across and say, give me my grand, right? But now, imagine if I took that same beam, and I put it on the roof of this building. And I span it over to the other building, same beam. But you're at the top of this building. How many of you walked the beam for this $8,000? Look at that, not one hand, okay? Now, watch me change it just a little bit. Imagine if I take the same beam, I put it on the roof of this building, I span it to the other building, and I put your children on the other side of that beam. and I set that building on fire.
Running.
How many of you want to be?
Yeah.
Oh, right. Now, I do this training a lot, and some people say, well, depending on what you did. But would you agree it got more serious, yes or no? All of a sudden, the money didn't matter. So you got to find something greater than you if you want to play the game. Take a minute to write down what you want out of this year. What do you want? You know what mine was? Retirement parents. Now, let me tell you where I was 15 years ago. I was making $29,000 a year selling cars. So retiring my parents is well out of my realm of possibilities, yes or no? But when I wrote that down, retire my parents, it didn't matter. I knew what I was playing for. Now, you want to play the game, right? First thing you got to do to play the game, you got to write down a list of 100 names. Period. And that's the minimum. Anybody here don't think they know 100 people? No, that's a trick question. Because if I was willing to give you $1,000 a name, how many of you come up with 100 names? How many get real creative quick and be like, mailman? Like, we don't know each other, but we know each other, right? The guy at the corner store, we don't know each other, but we know each other. See, you got to come up with a list of 100 names. This is one of the most important things you can do in the beginning of your business. My list was 160. Why? Because I figured the first 100 wouldn't do it. I got 60 more. So you want to write a list of 100 names, right? And then you want to practice the what?
Script.
The script. Practice the script. How many of you can recite the script right now? Okay, you guys can invite. If your hand's not up, practice the script. If you don't practice, how good is it going to be? No, you're going to be reading that phone going, hello, do you look at, what's the other person on the other end of the phone going to think? Right? Practice the script. And then you call all 100 people and you read the script to them. And if they say yes, you do what? Invite them to your living room. And you're on the way to winning the game. No different if I played the same game with your kids. How many of you have kids? Imagine if I played the same game with your kids. And I brought one of your children up here and I said, you want to play the game? What do you think the kid's going to say? Absolutely want to play the game. You want to win the game? Absolutely want to win the game. And I'll tell your child, you can have any toy in the world you want. Would they describe it to me? Would they tell me where you can buy the toy, and what the toy looks like, and how many batteries it takes? See, that's thing one, you got to get visual, yes or no? And I made that toy appear, and I said to the child, do you want the toy? And he says, yes, great, go out in the hall. And I gave the toy to this gentleman right here. And I say, hold the toy, hide the toy. And I brought your child in here, and I said, you want to play the game? Okay, great. First, here's the script. Do you have my toy? That's the script. And I make the child repeat it to me a couple times. You know, you have my toy. And I say, you start right over here with this beautiful lady. And you ask her, do you have my toy? And if she says no, you go to the next person. And when you find the person that says yes, you get the toy. How fast would a child cruise this room? Right? Do you have my toy? 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 Do you have my, right? Yeah. See, that's how a child plays the game. And that's how a professional network marketer plays the game. But here's the problem. We get involved in ACN. We're all adults. We have stories in our head, right? And we come in, and we're not that coachable, right? And we come in, and here's how we're playing the game. Do you have my toy? She says, no. I say, hold on a second. Are you sure you don't have the toy? No. Okay, hold on a second. Maybe I'm saying something wrong. You have my toy, you have my toy. You have my toy. No. Okay, here's what I want to do. I'm going to show you a picture of the toy. We're going to go to lunch tomorrow and talk about the toy. How many of you are sort of like that? How many of you are trying to convince people they look at other ways of making money? You gotta be childlike, yes or no? The ones that can call the most people and read that script to the fastest wins. How many of you got a lot more excited about winning at ACN? Now, here's the thing you're gonna realize. Some of the people that you think will do this won't. And the ones you think won't do it will, yes or no? That's reality. Don't let that slow you down. See, I sponsor people, I have them write a list, I practice that script with them, and I say, your goal is to call them all in 2 days. Does that sound that difficult? How many of you could make 50 phone calls over the next 2 days if it made the difference between you working the rest of your life or you're living residual income? How many of you could do that? That's all this is. That's all this is. Whoever can call the most people in the fastest. Guys, I just moved to Texas and I sponsored a guy, his name is Fabian Arbelez. Fabian was the number one ETL last month. He put 27 people in his group. He's been in the business for a little over 30 days. 27 people signed up. You know why? He sat down and called everybody in 2 days. I was like, man, if you read the script, they say yes or no, and you move on. And that's all he did. And he just went through his list faster than other people, yes or no. You got a sword. Swords. How many agree this is simple? How many would raise your hand no matter what I ask? Right? Now, the next thing you're going to be faced with, right? So, okay, great. I'm a sorter. I've got to sort people. People ask me what I do for a living. You know what I tell them? I'm a professional sorter. They said, what do you mean? I'm like, do you look at other ways of making money? If they say no, I say you're sorted. See how quick I am. And I move on to the next person. See, I'm not trying to convince somebody you look at other ways of making money. It's either a yes or a no. You're either open-minded or you're period. Period. See, let's be honest with ourselves. If we all had the chance to partner up with Verizon, knowing what we all know now, and we were the first group of people ever in New York, we're going to go out and market phone service, and this new company you never heard of called Verizon, and you're in, how excited would you be today? How many of you guys would be out of your mind? How many of you guys go to the Bentley dealer after this and be like, hold those two for me, I'm coming back, right? Why? Because you know what's going to happen. Do you realize our energy company is growing faster than Verizon did in its first 5 years? Let that sink in a second. You'll talk about right place, right time. So if your friend said, hey, it ain't going to work, knowing what you know now, would you listen to him?
No.
What would you say? Hey, I'll show you later, right? Don't worry, you'll see. Life leaves clues. Right? So that's the sort. Then the next thing you're going to be faced with is the emotional roller coaster. How many of you know what this is? No, honestly, how many of you know what this is? Guys, when I got involved in ACA, I was out of my mind. I saw the opportunity, and I was like, oh my God, everybody has to go. Like, you know when I filled that form out? Possibility entered my life and didn't exist. You know what the possibility was? Becoming wealthy. The possibility of living a dream life. The possibility of residual income, helping other people, doing all these great things. See, I didn't have that ability on the car lot, did I? But the possibility entered my life. See, I didn't go home and Google ACN. You know what I Googled? Mercedes-Benz. Why? Because I'm like, how many of you quit looking at those things? How many of you are like me? Remember when I was in high school and junior high? On the wall in my bedroom, I had a Lamborghini. I had a Ferrari. At all the new cars. But it seems like once you get older, what happens? You bring the posters down. Why? Because you wrap your life around your paycheck, yes or no? Well, you know what? I started the dream again. I started looking at all these things. I started looking at beach homes. I remember I went home that night. I was like, this is unbelievable. Now, guys, I didn't get excited about selling phone service. Like, when they said phone service, I wasn't like, I found it. This is it. I've been waiting to sell phone service. You know what I got excited about? There was a guy making 40 grand a month selling phone service. That's what I got excited about. I got excited because I was getting offered the same opportunity. That's what fired me up. I remember I went home. My brother and I stayed up all night. We were looking things up. We're like, oh, my God, everybody has a phone. We started to dream again. And then I woke up the next day with an ACN hangover. How many of you know what I mean? Right? How many of you, and this was me, I worked at a Toyota dealership. Remember the next morning I woke up and I'm driving that Camry to the dealership and the voices started talking to me. How many of you know what the voice is? Like, Mike, what are you doing? Mike, what did you get yourself into? Are you crazy, Mike? You're getting all excited about something you know a little bit about? How many of the voices talking to you? Guess what? They've never been right, so tell them what. But I went to the dealership, and I went in there, and I was excited. And I made my first mistake. I grabbed two guys. I remember these guys, Mike Dungell and Bob Pheasant, and today they're still at that same dealership. That's the case. And I brought them in my office,
and I closed the door, and I said, I found it. They're like, what are you talking about? I'm like, phone service! They're like, what do you mean? And then I gave them a drink of water with a fire hose, if you know what I mean. Like, I puked all over. We're going to get rich selling phone service. This is unbelievable. We can make money when people make phone calls. And after that was done talking, they went like this and started asking me questions. How many of you can relate to that? How many of the same thing happened to you? And I remember the first question was what's the name of the company? ACN. Okay. So how do you compete with Verizon? Well, you know, we actually can save people money over Verizon. So why would Verizon, when Verizon hears about you, you're going out of business. They're going to crush you. Like, okay. Then they asked me some more questions. Like, who showed this to you? I was like, Anna Jacobson. They said, the real estate agent? What'd she know about phone service? And here's what happened. I started to go from here to here. They were asking me some questions. I'm like, I didn't want to do it, but that's my question. Like, I should ask them that question. And I'm like, listen, you don't understand. There's a guy that came, and he was making a bunch of money, and we signed up, and they're like, you gave him money? I was like, $499, your money's gone. But here's what happened. I went from here to here. How many of you know what I mean?
Yeah.
I went from there to there. I remember that day, I ate lunch with these guys every day, but not that day. Why? Because they were now making fun of me. Here comes the telecom genius, get out of his way. You know, I remember the phone, I called my brother Pat. I said, Pat, I don't know if this is for us. He goes, what are you talking about? Like, we just signed up the night before. He's like, what are you talking about? I was like, well, Pat, I went to work, I grabbed these two guys, and said, man, they asked me some good questions, and we got to ask those people. And all of a sudden, you got to ask those people, you know? We got to ask those people at ACN. He goes, Mike, they told us not to talk to anybody about it. Now, Pat was always a little bit more coachable than me. I'm like, you're right. But here's where, so you know what I did is I kept my mouth shut. I was like, I'm not going to say nothing. I'm going to go to training this Saturday and just see what this is all about. And that's what I did. Now, my training wasn't close or convenient. Success usually isn't. Opportunities usually aren't, yes or no.
Yeah.
My training was in Columbus, Ohio. Now, I lived in Altoona, Pennsylvania. Columbus, Ohio was a big distance. It's probably a 4-hour, 5-hour drive, one way. Remember, we got up early. Pat and I went to the training. We got there early. We're out in the hall about 9:25. And you know what blew me away? There was a lot of people there in the hall excited. See, I'm coming out of corporate America or the carbon. You know who's excited on Saturday at the car lot? Nobody. Nobody. Right? And I'm like, this is great. Everybody's excited. They look good. This is great. Introducing ourselves. Where are you from? Where's okay, great. And then we go in the room and they start. I'm like, this is awesome. See, how many of you, when you get to work on Tuesday after Memorial Day, they'll stand up and start clapping for you? They're excited they're here, right? And I was like, this is great. And then I saw people that were having success. Some a little, some a little. Right? People that were excited about a future. Some of you made $1,000 a month, some people were making more. And I was like, okay, great. And then the guy that was doing the training was 26 years old. And he was making $40,000 a month. You know what blew me away? $40,000 a month. I was unbelievable. I was 33 years old making $29,000 a year. He's 26 years old making $40,000 a month. Come on, you gotta be kidding. And I like everything about him. I like his suit. I like his watch. I like his car. I even like his girlfriend. Oh, and he said something to me that day that no other human being has ever said to me in my life till that point. You know what he said? Because I went back to the meeting and that. He says, my goal is to make $80,000 a month. My head went, boom. I couldn't even think that big. $80,000 a month. He goes, but for me to do that, I got to help you make $40,000 a month. I was like, Pat, we found our new best friend. I'm like, this is it. You're going to help me? This is unbelievable. Fantastic. And we went back, and we went to work, and we wrote a list of 100 names, and Patrick and I remember we were going home practicing the script. I would invite Pat, he would invite me. I would invite Pat, he would invite me. We were like kids, practicing this script, going back and forth, and we started inviting. You know what blew me away? When my brokest friends, when I said, do you look at other ways of making money? And they said, no, I'm going. Life's making sense now. I can see why you're broke. Now, I didn't say that, but I'm thinking. Yes or no? I had to call 160 people to get 44 to say yes. Night of my meeting, 22 showed up. How many of you found out that only 50% show? Do you realize they're just saying no to you by not coming? They just don't want to say no to you because they're scared to hurt your feelings. But if they don't show up, it's just their way of saying what?
No.
No. Now here's what I did. I introduced the speaker and I sat down. That night, 8 people got started. I was on top of the roller coaster out of my mind. I'm like, this works, and this is great. The next morning, 2 people quit. How many of you have people quit? Congratulations, you can go SVP. Do you realize you can't go SVP without people quitting? So here's my advice. When you have someone to quit, you will. Here's my advice. Pick up the phone and be like, hey, look, I'm going SVP, and they told me I needed a quitter, and you're it, and move on. And move on. Greatest shift of wealth we ever see. See, here's what they say is you gotta guard your attitude. See, you gotta guard your attitude more than you guard your money. Yes or no?
Yes.
See, it's easy when everything's going your way to be positive, yes or no? Is it not easy for Ruman to be excited because he's a regional vice president and he has residual coming into his bank account and people signing up in his business? It's easy to be excited, right? See, where the real champions lie is when everything's going against you and you're fired up and positive. When people don't become your customer, or people say no, or they don't show up to your meeting, and someone says, how's that ACN thing? And you're like, going great.
Yes.
You got to find the positive in every situation. See, this has served me really well in life. You put me in any situation, I'll find the positive, because it takes a minute. And it's funny, when you go into a situation that's a negative situation and you find the positive, you can't think negative anymore, can you? See, when someone says no, I get excited now. If Neil said no, I'd be like, Neil, thank you very much. I thank no's more than I thank yeses. Why? After I'm done thanking them, they're like, no, I'm not getting started. No, thank you, I appreciate it. Why? Because you know what? They're saying, Mike, don't waste your time with me anymore. And I appreciate that, yes or no? Because I'm moving on to the next person. See, the more no's I get, I'm closer to a
yes.
Yes. Think about it. You're closer to a yes. See, you got to get on the roller coaster. See, here's what I loved about ACN. Keep the bar down. Keep the bar down. Keep the bar down. Now, this is what I loved about ACN. The company's the same for how many of you realize the company's the same for all of us? How many of you realize we're making history here?
Yeah.
I don't know if you know this. We're making history. Because last time I checked, does Con Ed sell wireless phone service?
No.
No.
Does Verizon Wireless sell gas?
No.
No. Does National Grid sell merchant services?
No.
We're the first company doing this all under one roof. You realize our energy company was the fastest growing energy company last year? Fastest. Year before, it was the 13th fastest growing company in America with a 16,000% growth rate. Do you realize our merchant service company just got an award as the fastest growing merchant service company in the United States, and we only opened doors 4 years ago? And you're just telling me it's going to work? And we're getting awards from the biggest accolade out there? And it don't work? The company's the same for everybody. Dude, there's people in this room getting rich. There's people in this room making a living, and there's people in this room that haven't made a dime, but the company's the same for everybody, yes or not?
Yes.
Now let's talk about the services. You know what I love about the services? We don't use them. Let's talk about wireless for a second, right? How many of you know where your phone is right now?
Yeah.
You're like pocket purse, right? How many of you know where the kids are? Oh, you can think a little bit more, right? Right? Now think about what we market wireless phones for. Has this ever happened to anybody? You get up late, you're running late, right? You gotta get the kids moving, life's coming at you 100 miles an hour. And you're like, okay, great, I get everybody in the car, we're moving it forward, and you're 1 mile, 2 mile, 3 mile, 4, 5 miles from home, and you realize what? You left your cell phone at home. What do?
Go back.
Also, you make yourself later, right? Really?
How many of you, when you misplace your cell phone, anxiety goes up a little bit? Right?
How are you? All right, hold on, everybody, nobody move, call me, text me, I gotta find my phone, right?
This is your market. I can't pay you not to use it. Think about that. I'll give anybody $1,000 right now, cash, you don't use electricity for the next 30 days. Anybody can think about that? Right? I mean, yeah, think about this. The services. See, people don't frustrate me.
I would never want to get paid on electric service.
Well, that's me.
I don't want to make money with my friends.
That's fascinating. I don't understand. See, I don't let people frustrate, right? Because the services and the companies are the same for everybody. See, the different variable here is you. Boy, I hated that part.
Yeah.
Because I had to work on me, that's what I know. I had to become better. See, I had to just change my thinking. That was it. Mike Mazur, 15 years ago, had broke thinking. That's why I was broke. That's why I didn't own the car I was driving, it was the dealerships. I didn't own the house I was living, I was renting. Because I had what? Broke thinking. But it wasn't until I started coming to these trainings and listening to people that had what I wanted. And took notes and copied. You know the great thing about ACN? You want to get rich here? All you got to do is get good at what?
Copying.
How many of you like that? Yeah. I went to Penn State University. After the second year, the college asked me to leave. And you don't know, I failed out. Now, my parents didn't laugh like you guys did. But that was reality. But imagine, first day at Penn State, if they said, look, if this college will let you copy.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, that would have been simple. I'd have sat next to the smart kid and said, write big. I'd have a doctorate right now, yes or no. Because I could come. See, that's what I loved about ACN. All I had to do was change my thinking. Now, it took a little bit of time, yes or no. See, that broke thinking was a habit. And I had to change the habit. I had to think, now, where did I do this? How did this happen? Trains like this. I never missed a train. Why? Because some weeks I needed the training, and some weeks the training needed me. Anybody know what I mean?
Exactly.
You guys remember some weeks I came in, people quit? Anybody quit? People didn't become customers? You know, people said no rudely, like, I'd never do anything like that. You're crazy for doing that. You need to go back to selling cars, Mike. And I came into the training, I'm like this. And I'd sit in the back, feeling sorry for myself. But then, all of a sudden, I'd hear somebody that had a success. And they were telling their story and how they recruited somebody, recruited somebody, recruited somebody. 20 people came in their business and 400 customers came in overnight and I'm back on top. And then there was some weeks the training needed me. How many of you know what I mean by that? There's some weeks I came in the training and I was the story going in, man, I just got this great guy. I just got this great girl. She signed up for the business. She went out. She got a big PBRs exploded. I never missed a training. And there's some people saying, well, every Saturday, yeah. So I got to give up.